Hello friends, welcome to this session. A series of AWS Solution Architecture examination preparation and the interview preparation for the AWS Solution Architecture. So let's start. So today's first question is, a solution architecture looking for a solution for low latency and high performance image sharing over the world, where hosting offsite on AWS. Which service will you suggest? So let's normalize the question over here. Basically, solution architecture are looking for the solution for the low latency and the high performance for image sharing. So it's a website deploy on the AWS and they need a requirement for the high performance and low latency. And which of the service you will suggest for solution against this problem? So there are the four options over here. The options one is AWS EC2, option two is AWS AutoScale, option three is AWS CloudFront, and option four is S3. Let's wait for the 5 seconds over here. Till time you can write your answer in comment section. You can judge your knowledge. So let's start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So answer is AWS CloudFront. AWS CloudFront is used for the CDN content delivery network, which distributed your information over the different edge location and making the caching over there, and which is really used for the high performance and the low latency. So you can go for the detail of the how CDN CloudFront works in our session, but here answer is the CloudFront. Let's move for the next question over here. What is the solution of EC2 storage in case of EC2 stop terminate data should be the persistent? So question is here, the in case of the EC2 stop or terminate data should be persistent. What would be the solution over here? So there are four options: RDS, DynamoDB, EBS, and S3. I hope you got the question over here. The EC2 instance, in case of stop and terminate, the solution for the data persistence which are created over EC2. So which is the best solutions over here? Let's wait for 5 seconds over here. This is a really easy question. And the answer is Elastic Block Storage. You can use Elastic Block Storage, which will be the use as a persistent storage. And in case of the EC2 stop terminate, the EBS will be the persistence. Let's move on to the next question. How stopping and terminate instance different from the each other? So in case of EC2, how the instance stop and instance terminate is different from each other? This is the interview question also, and answer is here. So in case of instance terminate, the instance will be the shutdown and the virtual machine that was provisioned for you that is permanently taken away, and you will not longer to be charged for instance usage. Any data that was stored locally on the instance will be lost. Any attached EBS volume will be the detached and deleted. However, if you attach the EBS snapshot to an instance at the boot time, the default option in the dashboard is to delete the attached EBS volume upon the terminate. So in case terminate, you will lose to your data. So let's move for the stop. So when you stop an instance, the instance will be the shutdown and virtual machine that was the provisional for you will be the permanently taken away, and you will no longer to be charged for the instance usage. The key difference between stopping and terminate instance is that attached bootable EBS will not be deleted. So in case of terminate, the EBS volume will be deleted. The data on EBS volume will remain after stopping, while the all information on the local hard drive and will be lost as usual. The volume will continue to persist in its availability zone, standard charge for the EBS volume will be the apply. So here the EBS will be there and the normal charges will be applied. Therefore, the you should only stop an instance if you plan to start again within a reasonable time frame, or otherwise you might want to terminate instance instead of the stopping it for the cost saving purpose. So there are the two core difference: the data availability after stop and data will be lost after terminate. Let's move for the next question. Which AWS service used for the storing application session state data? So which AWS service used for the storing the application session state data? So let's move for the answer. So answer is, sorry, the options over here is RDS, Elastic Cache, EBS and S3. You have to choose two answer here. So let's wait 5 seconds over here. Okay, so answer is AWS RDS and Elastic Cache. You can store your application state data in RDS, that's a database service, and Elastic Cache, that is a caching database service. So friends, thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to click on bell icon. We will meet again with some new questions. Thank you.